Hello, this is Kurt Worley, FX strategist and trader coach at FXBootcamp.com. Today is Monday, February 4th, 2013. We're actually in the midst of the New York afternoon session on the first trading day of the week here. Time of day isn't that relevant. It is worth noting that we're some eight hours away from the Reserve Bank of Australia's policy decision. That's the Australian Central Bank, their rate decision due out during Tuesday's Asian session. And that's why I wanted to focus on this pair, the Aussie-USD currency pair, which again, I'll refer to this the Aussie moving forward in this video. You're looking at an Aussie daily chart on the 1MT4 trading platform. Now, the Australian dollar really hasn't done that much of late, and I wanted to highlight that on this daily chart. You can see I've got a horizontal blue line at 1.04, the psychological level. And as I activate my drawing tool here, you'll see several occasions where this Aussie has bounced at 104, either flipping from down to up or from up to down. You see some cases where it flips from up to down there, down to up in here, up to down in here. You get the idea. On several occasions over the past several months, this 1.04 area or zone has affected price action on this pair. But it seems every time this pair sells off, like it did last fall, it got as low as about 1.05, which I'm highlighting now. That's the 1.05 area there, or as high as 1.06 psychological level. Correction, I said 1.05, I mean 1.0150. This is the 1.0150 zone in here, and 1.06, the 1.06 zone up in here that the Aussie has topped out near 1.06 on multiple occasions over the past several months. And so every time the Aussie sells off to as low as about 1.0150 or rises as high as 1.06, it's meant by buyers in the case of 1.0150 or sellers in the 1.06 zone, and always seems to make its way back to 1.044. So here we are after the Monday trading day is over. We're some 40 pips above 1.04 right now on the Aussie, and now we're waiting for the RBA rate policy decision due out a little less than 8 hours from now. So let's talk about what that can mean. First of all, I want to highlight some technicals here. We're above some 40 pips above 104. I do want to highlight the basis for this trend line, which you'll see in a later chart here. Got some highs there, some lows here, a high there. That's the basis. Actually, it's a high there as well. That's the basis for the red trend line you see on this daily chart, which you'll see on a short time frame in a moment. Let's take a look at a short time frame now. Here's an hourly chart for the Aussie showing price action since the open of the January 17th New York morning trading session. And this is highlighting some more recent important zones of both support and resistance. You see, I've got a red zone here, a red zone, the 1.0440 area. In fact, the Aussie just rose that zone recently and now off that by a few pips. The 1.0440 zone has affected price action over the past several days. So has the 1.0385 area, which I've highlighted here in green near the bottom right hand portion of the chart. So 1.0385 zone has affected price action, seems like, of late, and so has 1.0440. And then, of course, you see the 1.04 handle represented by a horizontal blue line. That's affected some price action of late as well. So here's the approach you can take to this RBA rate decision. First of all, we know that according to some data compiled by Bloomberg News, also according to a survey of some 28 economists conducted by Bloomberg News, we know from those sources that there's a 1 in 5 chance, according to economists surveyed and according to interest rate swaps data, and roughly 1 in 5 chance of an RBA rate cut. So the base case, there's greater odds, in other words, of the RBA standing pat and not raising rates, leaving their benchmark interest rate where it is, as opposed to a rate cut. But the according to forecasts, according to interest rate swaps data, if there's going to be a surprise move by the RBA, again, that's the Australian Central Bank, it's going to be a rate cut. Now, if you look at recent price action on this pair in response to recent RBA decisions, I researched that, and what I found is that in response to the RBA decision in recent early October, there was a surprise cut by the Australian Central Bank on the decision in early October. This pair dropped some 50 pips in 1 minute. As by contrast, in early December, when the market expected another rate cut but didn't get it, instead the RBA kept their benchmark interest rate the same level there, the Aussie actually rose by 40 pips. So you can probably expect a similar scenario today. Either the Aussie rises, this pair rises, maybe some 40, 50 pips in response to a no change decision in terms of the benchmark interest rate for the RBA, or if the RBA does surprise the market and, and, cut their benchmark interest rate by 25 basis points or 0.25%, then certainly a drop here is in store. So for you Asian session traders, you can consider, of course, a short at or into the 10.0440 zone. So if you can do the test of the 10.0440 area here, by the way, there's the trend line I mentioned earlier on the daily chart. That red trend line I mentioned on the daily chart is shown here. That trend line comes into play also near the 10.0440 zone just recently here. So for the for those expecting a rate cut, it would make a lot of sense to look for a chance to short this pair before the RBA announcement. So an opportunity, if one presents itself during the early part of the next Asian session, during Tuesday's Asian session, if you get a chance to short around 10.0440, certainly that would make some sense to look for a short and hope that the RBA delivers a benchmark or a cut of its benchmark interest rate by 25 basis points. If you want to go with the base case, the consensus, which is no change by the RBA, which would seemingly mean up for a while, maybe a 40 or 50 pip rise in the Aussie in response to that announcement, then you might get a chance to long around 1.04 the handle here. They're in the early part of Tuesday's Asian session. Perhaps if the Aussie drops this low, you'll get a chance to go long around 103.85. So those are the options for Aussie traders to perhaps to position yourself well in advance of, for hopefully maybe 2 or 3 hours in advance of the RBA rate decision, either a short around 10.0440 or a long around 10.0385. Now there is one more scenario for an Aussie bull planning on no change by the RBA, which seemingly might be bullish for this currency pair, the Aussie USD. And let me discuss that case before I end this video here. Here's a 15-minute chart for the Aussie. Let me adjust some lines here. There we go. You can see the Aussie reducing top down around 10.0440. One scenario worth considering, and again, this is going to happen several hours from now, if it happens at all. I'm envisioning over the next several hours the possibility of this. You can see support around here, around 10.0415 or so. Maybe we bounce around 10.0415. If you're not around for that, that's okay. What you might get is a bounce around 10.04 or 10.0415, and eventually rise above 10.0440 in the early part of the next Asian trading session. Maybe a rise as high as 10.0470, 10.0475. That was last week's high near 10.0475. If you get a pullback after that and a retest, or at least a near retest of 10.0440, maybe there's a chance to go long, and again, an early Tuesday Asian session trading, a chance to go long somewhere in that 10.0440 area, and hopefully you build a position over the say 2 or 3 hours in advance of the RBA rate decision, such that you've got a cushion of profit to work with before that rate decision, because that's not a rate decision. I would recommend you be at break even on an Aussie trade in either direction, long or short, given the potential for the Aussie to move some 40, 50 pips up or down, depending on the nature of the rate decision. By the way, even if there's no change by the RBA, I would take a close look at their statement. The RBA statement issued in conjunction with the rate decision could provide some clues as to their next move.